Hey, this is Annie.
And Samantha.
And welcome to Stefan Never Told You, a production of iHeartRadio.
And welcome to another edition of Feminist Around the World. You know, we're about to talk about an activist who actually has a bigger conversation that we don't really talk about in this specific episode, but being an Indigenous person who was also from an enslaved heritage and how they ended up in the area that they ended up in.
Mm-hmm.
And just the whole conversation about colonialism and what that does to Indigenous people in general. I mean, we've talked about that plenty of times, but when we put in with like an enslaved group of people on top of that, there's so many conversations to be had. And colonialism and colonization is quite a big conversation today as we're seeing some things happen in action. We haven't really gotten into it, but I think it just brings a bigger question of what happens to an Indigenous group of people when they are colonized and then enslaved, and then they are left with the remnants of trying to save the land that was ripped away from them. So it's quite a big, big scope of conversation. And we are going to talk a little bit, of course, because we know that these episodes are very, very short. We try to get in as much as we can in a short amount of time because we want to talk about as many people as possible. But she does bring up, as we've heard throughout our conversations about Indigenous communities, how race and ethnicity does play a bigger part when we talk about activism in the ecosystem and climate change and what that means for the Indigenous people. In this case, we're talking about Yurshell Rodriguez Hooker, who is an Afro-Caribbean Indigenous woman. And just that bigger play of that whole intersectional level that we don't talk enough about. I know we try, but it's hard to cover all the things that she has in her own life when it comes to being an intersectional advocate. And I think it's just important to note, as we are really kind of focusing on the environmental and climate change, it is a big conversation about how intersectionality is so important and how dangerous it is for those in those intersections. And that we should not ignore one for the other, and why, again, that is something that's huge in this conversation. So, with that note, yes, we are talking about Yurshell Rodriguez Hooker, who is an inspiring Indigenous climate activist who's been defending her land and her community for a long time now. She is a descendant of the Afro-Caribbean Roselle Indigenous group from the archipelago of San Andreas, Providencia, and Santa Catalina Islands, Colombia. Also, other part is, yes, this is going to be from obviously a different language because we talk mainly about international people. So if we get any pronunciations wrong, bear with us. If you would like to kindly correct us, that'd be wonderful because, yes, we're trying to do it based on the interwebs. And we have limited information, especially because we are kind of pigeonholed in the U.S. So go ahead and with that disclaimer. Mm-hmm. So from her early years, Hooker has been an advocate in the fight in climate change, and her heritage has been a big reason for her continued advocacy. In a 2020 article she wrote for Reach Not Preach, she says, quote, "I am from the archipelago of San Andreas, Providencia, and Santa Catalina Islands, located in the Caribbean Sea of Colombia. I am part of the native Afro-Caribbean Roselle ethnic group that for more than 200 years have lived in this small archipelago, being the guardians and stewards of Seaflower Biosphere Reserve, declared by UNESCO in the year 2000. As one of the most important ecosystems for health and sustenance of the world and the third largest coral reef. In recent years, our misadventures with climate change have put us in check. In less than 15 years, we have experienced the fierceness of two hurricanes, the first one, Category 3, named Beta in 2005, and second and most destructive, named Iota, Category 5 in 2020, which have left us in the position of high vulnerability and also with little capacity to respond to change. This was also confirmed by the Institute of Hydrology, Meteorology, and Environmental Studies, or IDEM, in 2017, where it placed us as the regions with the highest risk due to climate change and the one with the lowest capacity of adaptation."
And she continues, "Being from a Roselle Indigenous community and understanding the importance that our territory is for us, it is difficult to assimilate what is happening because we know as a community that we are not the ones causing it, or rather we are not directly responsible for the instability of the climate, But yet, we are first and most affected by catastrophes in our region due to our insularity and our geographical position, not listing the public politics and corruption we face in this country that are not in favor of the minorities or indigenous and ethnic groups. And with the continued effects and harm of climate change, especially to Indigenous communities, Hooker has been working to protect her community as well as fight for the human rights of Indigenous people through her work.
Right. She writes in that same article, "That is why I also understand that climate change cannot and must not be separated from the fight for human rights. The impacts of climate change disproportionately affect people who are already most vulnerable to its effects, such as Indigenous communities, peasants, women, children, and those who are displaced by climate change and other conflicts that are related. The human rights affected by climate change are countless and widely spread. So my efforts to address climate change also aim to address our affected human rights as Indigenous Roselle community. That is why in 2018, with 25 other young plaintiffs and the help of the NGO De Justicia, we sued our Colombian government to stop deforestation in the Amazon rainforest, one of the main sources of carbon dioxide emissions of our country, and we won the lawsuit."
And yes, she and a number of Colombian youths dared to push back on the government. In 2018, with the NGO De Justicia, they sued the government with these demands, quote, that the president, the ministries of environment and agriculture, the national parks and regional autonomous corporations, and the mayors and governments of the Amazon take action to stop the deforestation of the Amazon rainforest. Specifically, they ask that the government be ordered to submit a plan of action to reduce the rate of deforestation in the Colombian Amazon to zero by the year 2020. This was the commitment that President Juan Manuel Santos made at the 2015 Climate Summit in Paris. They also request that young people be taken into account in the decision-making of this process. And this is according to dejusticia.org. And yes, in an interview with news.sky.com, she explains why she was a part of the lawsuit when her island was 1,000 miles away, and she told them, "Saving the Amazon is a part of saving my own island. All the ecosystems are connected. So if you harm somewhere, if you do something good somewhere, it ripples through the other parts."
And I think, of course, this is that bigger conversation that we've been having about the youth being the forefront of this movement and really making a huge push and stride and being very vocal and bringing awareness to the situation. And our island has been greatly impacted from the downfall and ripples that have devastated their land. She spoke in another interview with ecobusiness.com about her interest in environmental advocacy, saying, "My interest in environmental conservation began from an early age. When I was 10 years old, I was already taking part in initiatives such as beach cleaning and mangrove protection." And I also noted that her current job is environmental engineer. So yeah, she's a pro. She knows what she's doing. And she continues talking about the hurricanes in 2020 and how they were able to protect their lands. After learning from their past incidents and advice she would give to others, she says, quote, "Harness nature-based solutions to build up climate resilience. When Hurricane Iota struck in 2020, the mangroves on our island broke up the force of the storm surges and reduced coastal damage."
Also, be self-sufficient. "We were able to rebuild our food supplies within a month because we grow our own crops. Speaking of which, support local produce where possible. Eat beef if you must, but purchase it from a local farm. Enact bans to safeguard the environment. The Roselle ethnic group has regulations that prohibit us from consuming seafood, such as lobsters and fish, during certain times of the year so as not to disrupt their reproductive cycles. Additionally, embrace a circular economy. Our tribe composts most of our food waste and uses it as fertilizers for our grounds. We also use debris that washes up on shores, such as seagrass, to weave furniture and fill mattresses. Lastly, adopt a common language for sustainability. This can be achieved by harmonizing green taxonomies among countries."
And I thought that was really great advice, especially from someone who's experienced so much throughout her life already. And I'm sure we're going to see so much from her and have so much more that we can learn from what she's doing, what she's learning, and how she's continuing to fight not only for her island, but for her entire country and honestly, the world. So yes, we will definitely keep a lookout for her name and see what she continues to do.
Absolutely. And as always, if we miss something, if you have any advice for who we should talk about next or any resources, please contact us. You can email us at stephaniamomstuff@iheartmedia.com. You can find us on Twitter at @MomStuffPodcast or on Instagram and TikTok at @StuffMomNeverToldYou. We have a Tee Public store and we have a book that you can get wherever you get your books. Thanks as always to our super producer, Christina, our executive producer, Maya, and our contributor, Joey.
Thank you.
And thanks to you for listening. Stuff I Never Told You is a production by iHeartRadio. For more podcasts from iHeartRadio, you can check out the iHeartRadio app, Apple Podcasts, or wherever you listen to your favorite shows.